Hey guys, welcome to Master Riff 134. In this lesson, I'm going to show you how to play the intro riff to 10,000 Lovers by TNT, which has got Ronni Le Tekrø on guitar. So tuning wise, I'm a half step down here. So I've got E flat, A flat, D flat, G flat, B flat, and then E flat. Riff starts off, first little bit, sounds like this. So what I'm going to be playing here is open E string. No pan mute, just open E string there. Beat 1. Then I've got a gallop rhythm in beat 2, but what I'm playing is basically 7th fret of the D string with the 2nd finger, and then 6th fret of the G string with the 1st finger. So I'm playing a little A major kind of tonality there, it's your root major 3rd. But I play that, and then I go and play basically a down up on the E string pan muted. Okay, so you're jumping here, this is the main part of this riff, you're jumping a lot between muting the E string or playing the E string and jumping up to the D and the G strings, missing that A. So watch that you don't hit the A string. So, after I've done my 7-6, I'm muted, I'm going to play 7 on the D and 7 on the G twice. Looking at on, you know, like three ands basically. And I've got vibrato in that as well. Just kind of rock it up a little bit. So slowly that goes. And picking wise there, I'm doing like a down, probably doing like a down, down, up, down, down. Then it leads into something that sounds like this. So what I'm going to play here is that E string, pan muted with a gallop rhythm, so it's a down, down, up. Yeah. Then I go back to my 7-6. Then I've got my open E string down up again. This is another gallop rhythm. Then the 2/8 this time is the 7-6 and the 7-7. Okay, so that goes. Then I have this little phrase that sounds like this. Okay, so what I'm playing here, this is pretty much just kind of E pentatonic minor with a little flat 5 in it. But I'm going to play 5-7 in the E string. 5 in the D string, then 7-6-5-3 on that E string. Okay, and it's all 16ths there, and you're coming in kind of on the E of your 3E and a. But the way to think about it is like it's a run that's going to end on that open E string as you start the kind of next two bars of the riff. Okay, so slowly those two bars, opening two bars, sounds like this. Okay, then basically I do that again. So you've just done this. Start again. So what I'm going to do here is slide down from 10th fret area in the E string to an A power chord. So I'm playing A, open A string, and then barring the 2nd fret of the D and G strings. And then basically, before the rest of the band and stuff comes in, I'm going to do this. So I'm playing like a 3-2 in the E string, and then 5-3 in the E string, vibrato. Rhythmically, that comes in at a weird point. It's like a little tee up. You're kind of coming in on the av beat 2, so it's 2E and av, like that. And that's your kind of first, your four bars of the riff. And pretty much what we do is do that another two times, you know, another two groups of four bars. So we're always starting with the first three bars. And it's the endings that are different. So this second ending sounds like this. So what I'm doing here is I'm going to play open E, pan mute, then 3-2 in the D string, on the E string, sorry, then 5-3 on that E string, just like we did before, but a little variation. We hit that 3rd fret of the E string twice, so slowly that little bit sounds like this. Yeah? And then the last time we do it before the verse starts, we end in that A power chord, and we simply just do 3-2-0 on the E string to finish it off. Okay, so let me play through the whole thing slowly then, you can hear those three different endings. Yeah. Yeah, so it's a really cool riff. I think what's really cool about it, and big part of Le Tekrø's style, I guess, is the kind of percussive nature to it. Particularly that bit there with the tone and stuff it's got. It's a really cool kind of punchy kind of vibe to it. So have fun with it, guys. It's a great riff, great tune, of course, old school. As usual, if you want access to the Guitar Pro tab for this or the SoundSlice animated tab page, that's all available to Master the Guitar patrons, as is access to all the previous lessons before and the additional lesson materials with the Master That Solo series, loads of backing tracks. There's also extra lessons that go up on the Patreon that you won't see anywhere else, basically. If you want, you can follow Master the Guitar on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter, all those usual places. And if you like the video, guys, please like and comment below. It helps keep the video alive in the YouTube algorithm. So have fun with it, guys, and I will hopefully see you soon.